Wait a minute, boys and girls. I think I see our bee. That's right, our school-wide expectations. Be responsible, be respectful, and be safe.
Good morning, Charles Wright staff and students. Welcome to Thursday, February 25th, 2021. I hope you are all having a wonderful week. I know I am. It's been a fun, busy week, but I am glad to be here with you. And I know that you are happy to be here with us. I have a few reminders, teachers. Please, third through fifth grade, sixth grade teachers, I sent you the list of students who have and have not completed the panoramic survey. If you have students on that list, please spend the next couple of days trying to get them to complete that panoramic survey. Right now we are only at 36%. We know that is not what Charles Wright is about. So I know it's been difficult, but we're gonna do our best for the next couple of days to get that survey complete. Also, IRIPs of my K-3 teachers, those are due by Friday. So please make sure if you have students who needed an IRIP that they are updated and ready to go. I think for now, we're still working on our count day numbers. I know Ms. Gray is busy reaching out to students that we haven't seen since before count day, and we need to make sure we get our friends in. So boys and girls, if you know somebody that's just not showing up for school, please call them and tell them we need them in school. And same, and teachers, if you can reach out to your kids that we haven't seen yet since count day, it would be very much appreciated. We know it takes a village. We know we are the village. We are a family. We are all in this together. I know I've made several phone calls today and met with a couple parents today about their student getting online to complete this learning and make sure that they get counted here at Charles Wright. So we know we're in this together. Please always reach out to me if you need extra support, or Ms. Gray. I know she's been working diligently. And that is all my announcements for this morning. I'm going to turn it over to Ms. Davis.
Thank you so much, Mrs. Jaywar. All right, I'm going to let Brene start us out because I see Brene is in the car and she is working overtime. She's out of school and she's still working overtime. So Brene, you go ahead. Can you give us the school-wide pledge?
Thank you, Ms. Davis. Good morning, staff and students. Please repeat the pledge after me. I am somebody. I may not look like everybody, but I am somebody. I feel like I am somebody. I look like I am somebody. I act like I am somebody. Everybody is somebody to somebody. Nobody but nobody can make me feel like a nobody. If you want to love somebody, then love me. If you want to help somebody, then help me. I am somebody. You are somebody. And don't you ever forget it.
Forget it. Awesome. Wonderful. All right. All right, Donovan, do you have some words of wisdom for us today?
Yes, I do.
All right. Thank Take
you.
It away.
Thank you, Ms. Davis. Yes, I have some words of wisdom for today. And good morning, staff and students. And remember, today is not just another day. It is a new opportunity, another chance, and a new beginning to embrace it.
Awesome. Thank you so much. All righty. All right, Ms. Dickerson. Take it away. What's it, some little data for us, attendance data?
That's right. And it has, as Ms. J. Ware said, it's been very busy. So I do give a shout out to all those staff members, those wonderful people that have been doing a great, great job. And on that note, for Wednesday, the 24th, we were at 81%. Yeah, so we're rising. And also the classrooms that had 90% or more were Ms. Hillman, Ms. Manko, Ms. Ballard in Thornhill, and Ms. Williams. And that's not it. The other day I had issues with Power School, but I was able to pull up those for Tuesday, February 23rd, that had 90% or more. And that was Ms. Manko, Ms. Lacey, and Ms. Heath. So that's a round of applause for all of them. Keep doing the good work, and thank you for all the help that I've been receiving as well with those calls. Yep, so parents, if you're out there and you know some of your friends or families that have not been logging on and signing in, please reach out to us, to the school. We are here for you all. So that's back to you.
Thank you so much. That's why we need you virtually, boys and girls. Come on, log in. Virtual school is hot and is ready. All right, so I do have a Black History person that we're going to highlight today. And that person is Ida B. Wells. Ida B. Wells was born into slavery in Mississippi on July 16th, 1862. Less than a year before Emancipation Proclamation of 1863 freed enslaved people. After moving to Tennessee when she was about 20, Wells began writing for Black newspapers, speaking out against segregated schools, which forced Black children to go to separate schools, and other forms of discrimination in the South. And that is our Expect Respect Moment in Time Black History theme.
And here is a short clip of the wonderful Black History program that was put on by Mrs. Lambert's kindergarten class.
World's greatest. I am a mountain. I am a tall tree, oh, I am a swift wind sweeping the country. I am a river down in the valley, oh, I am a vision and I can see clearly. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky. I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it.
All righty. Well, oh, one other thing, boys and girls, you have been doing a wonderful job staying out of that chat the last couple of months, but it's starting to rise and we are watching. Do not chat and reach out to other students online, because if you do, we will find out. We have some wonderful parents, and parents are letting us know what's going on. And we're going to call your parent and let them know what you're doing. So stay off that chat unless you have permission from your teacher. All right.